This video shows how to configure and use the Microsoft 365 Defender connector in Microsoft Sentinel, our cloud-native SIEM for modern SecOps. It requires no infrastructure, so you don't have to worry about scaling up, and takes just minutes to set up. As for cost, you pay only for the Azure resources you use. Of course, Microsoft 365 Defender can stream incidents into Sentinel, and they keep them synchronized, both ways, and that's what I'm here to tell you about. Turning on integration takes just minutes. In Sentinel, on the Data Connectors page, search for and select Microsoft 365 Defender in the gallery. Then select Open Connector page. Before getting started, a prerequisite check helps to ensure you have the right permissions, and I'm good to go here. Now, I can enable synchronization of incidents and alerts between Microsoft 365 Defender and Microsoft Sentinel. We do recommend that you leave Turn Off All Microsoft Incident Creation Rules for these products enabled to avoid duplicate incidents. Just select Connect Incidents and Alerts, and boom, connected. Next, I need to enable integration of on-premises identities via Microsoft Defender for Identity. I'll skip that because I'm cloud only, but I'll enable the collection of raw advanced hunting events from each workload. Just select the checkboxes next to the tables containing the event types you want to collect, or select them all, and then select Apply Changes. On the connector page, the graph shows that Sentinel is ingesting Microsoft 365 Defender data. There's a line for incidents, alerts, and events from each Defender workload. Everything works, so I'll dig into synchronized incidents next. In Microsoft Sentinel, select Incidents. Microsoft 365 Defender incidents appear in the Sentinel Incidents queue shortly after Microsoft 365 Defender creates them. Select Product Name, followed by Select All to deselect all the products, and then select Microsoft 365 Defender to see only those incidents. Selecting an incident opens its details side pane. Bidirectional syncing helps ensure that changes you make to the assignment, status, or severity stay the same in both places. This is immediate in both directions, so everyone is always working from the same information. There are many other details about the incident, like the product names involved, evidence associated with the incident, and the tactics and techniques observed. You can also act on this incident, like opening the investigation, running an ad hoc playbook in Azure Logic Apps, creating an automation rule to act on similar future incidents, like automatically assigning owners or triggering a playbook, or creating a team in Microsoft Teams for incident collaboration. You can also quickly navigate to an incident in Microsoft 365 Defender by selecting Investigate in Microsoft 365 Defender at the top of the Details side pane. I'm going to dig into this incident in Sentinel, however, so I'll select View Full Details. The incident page provides Microsoft 365 Defender details correlated with other sources, including third-party products, to give you a complete picture. On the Overview tab, the Incident Timeline tile lists the alerts involved in the incident, sorted most recent to oldest. As the incident evolves in Microsoft 365 Defender and more alerts are added, the incident also updates in Sentinel. Select an alert to view its description, severity, status, products involved, entities, and more. The Entity tile is a quick view of the entities involved in the incident, and selecting one takes you to the Entity tab for more details. The entity details contain helpful information about the entity, including a timeline of related alerts, bookmarks, anomalies, and log activities for the entity. Alerts related directly to the specific incident have a blue shield next to them. Everything else has a gray shield next to it. Seeing unrelated alerts can help give context, so there is value in seeing them here, and you can quickly add them to the incident by selecting the plus sign next to it. Last, the Insights tab contains queries defined by Microsoft security researchers to provide contextual data about the entity. You can always open the Entity page by selecting View Full Details, and can kick off a Logic Apps playbook for this entity by selecting Run Playbook. For example, blocking a user or resetting a password. Another useful capability is to add an Indicator of Compromise, or IOC, to threat intelligence. For example, to do that for an IP address, select the Meatball menu, followed by Add to TI. I'll head back to the overview to finish up. Like I showed before, the top top Insights tile is a roll-up of those entity insight queries across multiple data sources, specially selected to help you triage quickly and understand the scope of the incident. These insights are aggregated, but have a link to the query in Log Analytics, so you can see the full data set and drill in for more details. Finally, the Similar Incidents tile contains the top 20 similar incidents over the past 14 days, with a similarity reason. Select the information icon to see individual similarities for more context. Microsoft Sentinel, our cloud-native SIEM, integrates seamlessly with Microsoft 365 Defender. For more information about using Microsoft 365 Defender with Microsoft Sentinel, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.